السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي على الصلاة.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله عز وجل وأحسن الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وإن شر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. ثم أما بعد، يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى في كتابه الكريم: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اركعوا واسجدوا واعبدوا ربكم وافعلوا الخير لعلكم تفلحون. الله سبحانه وتعالى says in the Quran what it means: O believers, bow down in ruku' to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and make sujood to Him. And worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and do what is good, in order that you may be successful. In this ayah, my dear brothers and sisters, we see how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had specified four reasons for success in this life and in the hereafter. The first one, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, irka'u, bow down, make ruku' to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The second one, He said, wasjudu, make sujood, prostrate to Allah azza wa jal. And the third one, He says, wa'budu rabbakum, worship Allah, your Lord. And the last one, He says, وَفْعَلُوا الْخَيْرَ, do what is good. And the result will be that you will be successful in this life and in the hereafter. Today we're talking about number four reason for success, which is doing what is good. Do what is good. إِفْعَلِ الْخَيْرَ. فعل الخيرات كان من دأب الأنبياء والمرسلين، حيث إن الله عز وجل أوحى إليهم أن يفعلوا الخيرات. قال سبحانه وتعالى في كتابه الكريم: وأوحينا إليهم فعل الخيرات وإقام الصلاة وإيتاء الزكاة وكانوا لنا عابدين. Doing what is good is one of the main characteristics and attributes of the prophets and the messengers. It was actually revealed to them from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to do what is good. Allah says in the Quran, and we revealed to them, meaning to the prophets and to the messengers that are mentioned in this context, in these ayat, we revealed to them to do what is good, فعل الخيرات, to establish the salah, وإقام الصلاة, to give in charity, وإيتاء الزكاة, and they used to be good worshippers to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَكَانُوا لَنَا عَابِدِينَ. My dear brothers and sisters, doing what is good or goodness is a very comprehensive term that includes basically every good thing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands us to do or recommends us to do or encourages us to do, or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala specifies or mentions a great reward for that action or that deed. And it includes so many things in our life, including but not limited to the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with all its aspects, the good manners, the respect that we should give to the people, good treatment of others and kindness to others, mercy and compassion. Count it. Just put thousands of lines under this term, goodness. Do what is good. وَفْعَلُوا خَيْرًا لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. Our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make him able to establish what is good. He used to say in the hadith, اللهم إني أسألك فعل الخيرات وترك المنكرات. He used to say, O Allah, I ask you to guide me to do what is good and to make me stay away from what is bad. My dear brothers and sisters, doing what is good is not only the attribute and the characteristic of the prophets and the messengers, it is also the attribute of the believers in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it should be the attribute of every Muslim. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the surah that is named after the believers, Al-Mu'minun, Surah Al-Mu'minun. In this surah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions how the true believers race and compete with each other towards the good thing, to do what is good. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ هُمْ مِنْ خَشْيَةِ رَبِّهِمْ مُشْفِقُونَ وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ بِآيَاتِ رَبِّهِمْ يُؤْمِنُونَ وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ بِرَبِّهِمْ لَا يُشْرِكُونَ وَالَّذِينَ يُؤْتُونَ مَا آتَوا وَقُلُوبُهُمْ وَاجِلَةٌ أَنَّهُمْ إِلَى رَبِّهِمْ رَاجِعُونَ أُولَئِكَ يُسَارِعُونَ فِي الْخَيْرَاتِ وَهُمْ لَهَا سَابِقُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, describing the true believers, those that they tremble out of fear from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, هُمْ مِنْ خَشْيَةِ رَبِّهِمْ مُشْفِقُونَ. Those who believe in the revelation of Allah that came to the prophets and to the messengers, including the last and the final testament of our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Holy Quran. وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ بِآيَاتِ رَبِّهِمْ يُؤْمِنُونَ. Those who do not associate a partner with Allah in their worship and in their actions. لَنَّهُمْ بِرَبِّهِمْ لَا يُشْرِكُونَ. Those who give what they give for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they are even afraid that it is not going to be accepted from them. يُؤْتُونَ مَا آتَوا وَقُلُوبُهُمْ وَاجِلَةٌ. Because they know that sooner or later they are going to go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to return to Him. Allah says at the end of these ayat, those ones with these qualities and attributes, they are the ones who vie and compete and race with each other towards that which is good. أُولَٰئِكَ يُسَارِعُونَ فِي الْخَيْرَاتِ وَهُمْ لَهَا سَابِقُونَ And they will win the race. My dear brothers and sisters, just to give you examples from the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam about what is good, what are the actions that are considered as good or the best in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For example, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu ta'ala anhu يسأل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أي الأعمال أحب إلى الله الصلاة على وقتها ثم ماذا بر الوالدي ثم ماذا الجهاد في سبيل الله. This is Abdullah ibn Mas'ud رضي الله تعالى عنه asking the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم a messenger of Allah, what is the most beloved action to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said to him to pray on time. Whenever the time of the salah starts, you leave everything and you do the salah. That's doing what is good. And then he said, and what is next to that? The Prophet ﷺ said, to obey, listen, and be kind and nice to your parents. Respect your parents, be nice to them. Birrul walidain. Birrul walidain, listening to them, respecting them, honoring them, appreciating what they do for the kids. This is one of the goodness. It is something that is considered as khayr. It is good. And then he asked the Prophet ﷺ, what is next? He said, jihad fi sabilillah, which is a striving heart in the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Another hadith, another example, from the sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ to teach us what is good. We need to know what is good to do it. When the Prophet ﷺ was asked, ayyul a'mal afdal? What is the best righteous and good deed? And you notice here that the answer of the Prophet ﷺ is always different depending on the situation of the questioner or the person who is asking the question. Or the wisdom behind the variation in the answer is to teach us different aspects of goodness in our life. Different aspects of goodness in our life. Not to just get stuck to something, and if we cannot do it, then we will get stuck right there and we will not be able to gain the reward. That's not the case, my dear brothers and sisters. Subhanallah. There is a person that he will be able to fast many days. This is good. There is someone else that might not be able to fast, but he might be able to perform more optional prayers. That is also good. There is someone that might not be able to perform more optional prayers, but he is enjoying reading the Quran more frequently, more than once, every week maybe. This is also good. There is someone that is in the habit of giving any charity. This is his habit, this is his way, this is what he likes. This is good. There is someone that is in the situation of helping the people. And this is also good. So goodness covers so many aspects of our life. So another example from the Sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ, when he was asked, O Messenger of Allah, what is the best righteous action and deed? And the Prophet ﷺ said, Iman billahi wahda. His answer to this question is different from his answer to Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu ta'ala. He said to believe in Allah, the one and only God. And then what is next? O Messenger of Allah. Again, he emphasizes on striving hard in the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, spreading the da'wah and conveying the message to the people. And then what's next, O Messenger of Allah? Now in this hadith, he is adding something also, something extra. He said, حَجَّةٌ مَبْرُورَةٌ أَوْ بَرَّةٌ تَفْضُلُ سَائِرَ الْعَمَلِ كَمَا بَيْنَ مَطْلِعِ الشَّمْسِ وَمَغْرِبِهَا. An accepted hajj that will be considered as the best righteous action and good deed in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and it will be having a great reward as you can see the distance between the sunrise and the sunset. So in this hadith, the Prophet ﷺ had given another example of what is good. What should we do and what should we learn as far as the good things to do in our life. In another hadith, the Prophet ﷺ was asked by Abi Umama, and Abu Umama, the Prophet ﷺ advised him, he said to him, عَلَيْكَ بِالصَّوْمِ فَإِنَّهُ لَا عِبْلَ لَهُ. He said, continue fasting as many days as you can. There is no reward that is equal to fasting. He had given him a different answer. Another one asked the Prophet ﷺ about the best righteous action and good deed, O Messenger of Allah. قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم الحال الملتحل. قال يا رسول الله ما الحال الملتحل؟ قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم صاحب القرآن الذي يضرب من أول القرآن إلى آخره كلما حل ارتحل. يعني كلما أنهى القراءة بدأ قراءة القرآن مرة أخرى. And this is what is good. And the Prophet ﷺ, was asked, O Messenger of Allah, what is the best righteous action and deed? He said, Al-Hal al-Murtahil. He says, the one who reaches the end and then keep going. He said, the one who reaches the end and then keep going. They said, O Messenger of Allah, who is that person that reaches the end and then keep going? The Prophet ﷺ said, the one who memorizes the Quran or who reads the Quran doesn't necessarily the one who mean that the one who memorizes it. He said the one who starts the Quran from the beginning, reading it, until he reaches all the way to the end, finishes the Quran, and then whenever he finishes, he restarts again. That is known as al-hal al-murtahil, the one who reaches the end and then keep going. So in this hadith, we see the Prophet ﷺ had given another example of goodness. And in another hadith, the Prophet ﷺ had guided us that sometimes when you overdo something that you might get bored of doing it. So he said, variate in the actions and the deeds. And in the meantime, even if you do less, but it is continuous, it is the most beloved way to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When he was asked, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, أَدْوَمُهَا وَإِنْ قَلْ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهَ أَيُّ الْأَعْمَالِ أَحَبُّ إِلَى اللَّهِ. What is the most beloved action to Allah azza wa jal? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the one which is continuous, even if it is less. So the Prophet ﷺ is guiding us how to continue doing the good. Not to overwhelm our things with something and then to stop it after that and to get bored of doing it, but to continue doing as much as we can. In another hadith, the Prophet ﷺ also said, أَيُّ الْأَعْمَالِ أَحَبُّ إِلَى اللَّهِ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. When he was asked, what is the most beloved action to Allah? قال أن تموت ولسانك رطب بذكر الله. The Prophet ﷺ said, to die while your tongue is moist with the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Your last word in this life will be لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله. And whoever his last speech and his last word in this life is كلمة التوحيد لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله, he is guaranteed Jannah. My dear brothers and sisters, in another very beautiful hadith, the Prophet ﷺ had indicated who are the most beloved people to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and what is the most beloved action to Allah azza wa jal. Another variation and another guidance, another instruction to that which is good. أَحَبُّ النَّاسِ إِلَى اللَّهِ أَنْفَعُهُمْ لِلنَّاسِ. The most beloved people to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are those who are more beneficial to the people, those who help the people. أَحَبُّ النَّاسِ إِلَى اللَّهِ أَنْفَعُهُمْ لِلنَّاسِ وَأَحَبُّ الْأَعْمَالِ إِلَى اللَّهِ سُرُورٌ تُدْخِلُهُ عَلَى قَلْبِ مُسْلِمٍ. And the most beloved action to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is happiness that you give or you cause to a Muslim. The happiness that you give to a Muslim, you do something for him and you make him happy because of what you have done for this person. أحب الأعمال إلى الله سرور تدخل على قلب مسلم. And then the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم gives some examples. He said, تكشف عنه كربة, you remove distress from him. أو تقضي عنه دينا, you repay his debt. أو تطرد عنه جوعا, or you give him the food, you provide him with the food, and you satisfy him, and you fill his stomach after he was hungry. And the Prophet ﷺ also said in the same hadith, أو تطرد عنه جوعاً، أن يسأل ولي أن أمشي في حاجة مع أخي أحب إلي من أن أعتكف في هذا المسجد شهراً. He said that I prefer to go with my brother to help him achieve what he is looking for, to help him obtaining what he is seeking, than to make i'tikaf in my masjid for 1 month. And we know how big is the reward of praying in the masjid of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and how big is the reward of making i'tikaf in the masjid of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, if you walk with your brother until you help him achieve or get what he is in need of, this will be considered in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala better than spending 1 month for i'tikaf in the masjid of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, وَمَنْ كَفَّ غَضَبَهُ سَتَرَ اللَّهُ عَرَّتَهُ. And the one who restrains his anger, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will cover his faults and his mistakes, and Allah will forgive his sins. وَمَنْ كَظَمَ غَيْضًا وَلَوْ شَاءَ أَنْ يُمْضِيَهُ أَمْضَاهُ مَلَأَ اللَّهُ قَلْبَهُ رَجَاءً يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. And whoever restrains his anger and his attitude and does not get angry, and if he can avenge, he will avenge. يعني he has the ability and the authority to revenge from his enemy. But he did not do that for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah Azza wa Jalla will fill his heart with the hope in the day of judgment. وَمَنْ مَشَى مَعَ أَخِيهِ فِي حَاجَةٍ حَتَّى تَتَهَيَّأَ لَهُمْ أَثْبَتَ اللَّهُ قَدَمَهُ يَوْمَ تَزِلُّ الْأَقْدَامِ. And whoever walks with his brother until he meets his needs and he helps him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make his feet firm on the day of judgment, the day in which all the feet will be slipping away because of the fear from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My dear brothers and sisters, we see how Prophet Yusuf alayhi salatu wa salam, in the most difficult time of his life in jail, and he has the opportunity to go out when they sent a messenger to him asking him about the interpretation of the dream, and he knew it, but he had given it without asking them, let me go out first. He said, no, I will not restrain and hold the knowledge. And this is good when the Muslim has the knowledge and learns it and gives it to others, teaches others this knowledge and acts according to it. This is also good. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَافْعَلُوا الْخَيْرَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. أو كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم, التائب من الذنب كمن لا ذنب له. ادعوا الله وأنتم مقبلون. الحمد لله رب العالمين, صلاة الله وسلامه على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. I want to remind you with a few announcements that we have inshallah today, tonight and tomorrow night, the family halaqa on the Zoom and the Facebook, inshallah ta'ala after Maghrib, and the online Saturday school from the masjid is inshallah tomorrow at 10 o'clock. Valakisa school registration is open, and youth discussion and story is tomorrow at 2 o'clock. And please do not forget to support and help the masjid. The boxes are at the exits of the masjid, inshallah ta'ala. And I remind our brothers who are praying upstairs, please, when you exit from the back door, inshallah. When you exit, after the salah, exit from the back door. نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى في هذا اليوم أن يغفر لنا ذنوبنا. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا واستر عيوبنا واشرح صدورنا وبلغنا مما يرضيك آملنا. اللهم إنا نسألك الهدى والتقى والعفاف والغنى ومن العمل ما ترضى برحمتك يا ارحم الراحمين. اللهم ارحمنا برحمتك الواسعه يا حي يا قيوم. اللهم اشف مرضانا وارحم موتانا. اللهم اشف مرضانا وارحم موتانا. وصل اللهم وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى اله وصحبه اجمعين. واقم الصلاه, ان الصلاه كانت على المؤمنين كتابا موقوتا.